In this video, let's talk about some of the ways you can unlock some of the hidden power features that are hiding in plain sight. So we come into our admin, we go into property, we're gonna click on property settings. And the very first thing that I like scrolling down to see is my enabling of the demographics and interest report on? Can I see this data? I wanna be able to get more information around my users. This is the stuff that comes in from DoubleClick that's out there that Google is collecting, and they can share it with analytics so that you can see it and make some analysis on it, but you have to give it permission because there are certain things you have to make sure you're agreeing to certain privacy statements and policies. Now, if you don't see enabled demographics and interest reports, you are probably seeing Google's new program, which is called Google Signals. So that could also be a possibility. It basically does the same thing, and it helps to connect all of the user data coming into your Google Analytics. And you wanna make sure you have that turned on. Why? Because when you do that, if you come into your audience reports, you will actually have a ton of data coming through in your demographics. You actually see age and gender. If you see interests, you can go into the in-market segments. So people that are using your site, these are the other types of products and services they are interested in. And then affinity categories are actually other topics that they are interested in, not necessarily for purchase, but just other things that they like. So you can learn a little bit more and maybe build some buyer personas. So some really cool things that you can do with your demographics reports, but you have to have it linked first in Google Analytics. Now, speaking of things to be linked, we also wanna make sure that you're linking all the third-party products that you can into Google Analytics so it can store that data. In particular, for most people that are watching this, you're gonna install Google Ads or link Google Ads, assuming this is previously known as Google AdWords, but Google Ads now, so make sure you link that if you're sending any sort of Google Ads traffic. And especially if you're doing anything with search, you wanna make sure you've got Search Console hooked up and actively coming into your Google Analytics. Now, fortunately, you can actually link this up in the very near future. They will automatically start linking Search Console into Google Analytics, which will be great. But for now, make sure that you double check it going into your products and making sure that Search Console is linked, because AdWords data coming in will actually help you. We can pull it up here to show you where it would be. Under your acquisition, you will actually see all this Google Ads reports start filling in because of this AdWords link. And then here in your Search Console reports, all of these reports fill in because of this link. Without those links actually set up, you are just not unlocking these incredibly powerful features of Google Analytics. So you want to make sure that you do that as well. All right, now it is your turn. I would love to hear how you are actually applying this to your own business. So be sure to leave a comment below and let me know that. Also, if you love topics around Google Analytics, like I do, you want to make sure that you're notified when new videos come out. So just be sure to like and subscribe to the CXL channel to make sure that you're on that list.